Hello guys, so in this video I will talk about bagging, boosting and stacking. These are basically machine learning techniques which are used for better predictions. These are strong learners which can predict in a robust manner. And so let's begin with the bagging algorithm. How does this technique work? So it is a basically ensemble method which uses base classifiers to train the model. In bagging, we select multiple samples from the training data set to train a base classifier. It is used when the base classifiers are very sensitive to different samples of training set. Let's say we have a binary classification with class 1 and class 2. Suppose 20 same base classifiers, say 20 decision tree, are trained on the training data set with different variations of the training data set. And while testing, if a certain observation is classified as class 1 by 15 models and rest 5 models classify it as class 2, then the observation will be classified as class 1 instead of class 2, because the majority of the models have classified it as class 1. So keeping in mind, in bagging we use the same algorithm like decision tree, but we are using number of them, like 20 decision tree or 40 decision tree, and each of this decision tree will be trained on different sample of the same training data set, different variations of the training data set. Now coming on the boosting, it is an algorithm in which we train in sequential manner. In this we train iteratively the same base classifier. So the base classifier remains the same, but we put the weights on the observations, and how we will see this. The ith classifier correct the mistake which were made by the previous classifier. As I told you, this is the sequential approach in which we have 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on models. So second model is trying to learn from the first model, third model is trying to learn from the second model, and the 10th model will be learning from the 9th model. And what they're learning? They're learning the mistakes, learning from the mistakes which the previous algorithm has made. Now moving forward, more weight is given to the misclassified observation. The final classifier is equal to the weighted mean of all these weak classifiers which are trained in the sequential manner. So say we started with the first decision tree and we iteratively do the training of the second and third, and third is learning from the second and the fourth is learning from the third, and we do it iteratively for say 100 iterations. So all these 100 iterations we have 100 models, and each of the model is learning from the previous one, and now what we get is the final model, which is the basically the weighted mean of all these weak base classifiers. And these weights can be approximated as accuracy of each base classifiers. Now again, if we take an example, a little bit describing about it, let's say we started with decision tree which splits the data at each node by asking questions, binary questions, to improve information gain at each current iteration. So during the training, current decision tree try to make much better splits than the previous decision tree, because the previous decision tree has made some mistakes, and so the current one tries to improve the accuracy by putting the more weight on the previously misclassified observations. So now coming over to stacking. So in stacking, we try to extract more and more and more features from the given data by using several models. Then these extracted features are then used for the next layer of several models. And how this works, let's see. So say we have a first layer of several models. Let's say we have models like XGBoost, Random Forest, Extra Trees. These are different classifiers which have been trained on the same training data set. And then we extract the predictions from all these models. These predictions are basically the probabilities for each of the observations. Now these probabilities from all these three classifiers are used as features or columns on which the next layer of several models are trained. So the next layer will not be using the training data set. Instead, it will be using the features which are extracted from the first layer of the models, which are basically probabilities or predictions. Finally, we extract the probability from the second layer, which are basically the predictions or probabilities, and then we average all these probabilities from all the several models of the second layer to get a single probability for each observation. Thank you for watching this video.